All of you, young minds, talented, bright kids, all doing your bit towards a better India. In fact, this campaign is indeed an innovative, a 360-degree campaign involving people from all walks of life towards a better India. If we focus on better swasthya, better swachhta, and better vatavaran, we'll be leaving behind a better bhavishya, better future for all of you. Now, many of you, as you are growing up, you have role models, right? You have been following personalities, their journeys, and you've been inspired by these people. So today, we put together a fantastic panel comprising young achievers and youth icons. For you, they may be stars. They're excellent at what they do today. They're extremely successful, but they've gone through their share of struggles as well. So today we're going to ask them, how can they use their image and their power to bring about a change towards a better India? So ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please put your hands together for our fantastic panel, Better India's campaign ambassador and a hugely popular actor, Sushant Singh Rajput. Lovely to have you here. Sushant, of course, in his school days, I don't know whether this has come up in your discussion so far, lekin Sushant apne school ke dino mein ladkiyon ko impress karne ke liye Shah Rukh Khan ki mimicry karte the. Kya ye sach hai?
Ji, bilkul.
Lekin aaj aapko ladkiyon ko impress karne ki zarurat nahi hai because they are already your big fans.
Are you guys? Yes.
Is there anybody out here who's not a fan of Sushant Singh Rajput? It's just not possible, is it?
Don't raise your hand, please.
Okay, now joining us on the panel, well, she's India's star. She won a billion hearts. She missed a medal at the Olympics just by a whisker. She's Padma Shri Deepa Karmakar. Deepa is the only Indian gymnast to have qualified for an Olympic final. And she is the only, probably the only fifth woman in gymnastics history to do the most difficult vault, the Prodanova vault. And with her, we also have her coach, Dronacharya awardee, Shri Bishweshwar Nandi. Nandi ji, aaiye, please. Aaj agar Deepa jo kuch bhi hain, wo coach saab ki wajah se hain, bahut bahut shukriya, aane ke liye bahut bahut dhanyawad.
Good evening.
Well, Indian mountaineer and the youngest girl to scale the highest peak, Mount Everest, at the age of 13, Malavat Purna. Purna,
hello.
Everest par chadhai sirf isliye karna chahti thi taki wo sabit kar sake ki ladkiyan kuch bhi kar sakti hain. और हम खुशकिस्मत हैं कि पूर्णा के साथ उनके पिताजी श्री देवीदास जी भी हमारे साथ ऑडियंस में मौजूद हैं. बहुत बहुत स्वागत है आपका सर. बैठिए बैठिए सर, बैठिए. आपका बहुत बहुत स्वागत है. अभिराज पाल, सीईओ अर्बन क्लैप, कंसिडर्ड टू बी एंड रिकग्नाइज एज वन ऑफ द फास्टेस्ट ग्रोइंग स्टार्टअप्स इन इंडिया. अभिराज, वेलकम. Suchita Salvan, a budding entrepreneur who's making, creating waves in the online content world, founder of the Little Black Book. And one of the most influential names in the Indian art world, Neha Kirpal, founder of the India Art Fair. Hi, Neha. So, Sushant, I just want to ask you, before we start this discussion, I just want to ask you one thing. After hitting the helicopter shots, and now you're flying high. Yeah, it's going to take me a while to get here. Thank you. You have been flying high. You're preparing for your role of an astronaut in your next film, Chanda Mama Durke. Have you, by any chance, come straight from the U.S. Space and Rocket Center for this Better India campaign today?
Yes, I was there since quite a few days. Hmm. And all those theories and all those laws that I've been learning since a long time, but those were just theories in my head. But for the first time, I got to experience multi-axis and zero gravity and 3G and 4G. And it felt like it was one of the best experiences ever that I've had.
And sitting in the simulator and going through things for the first time?
Yes, of course. All the Orion and all, I flew. Yeah. And I mean, like 9 out of 10 times I was successful. So I was like very, very happy with the performance.
But Sushant, for you, the journey from TV, from television to films, it's been not easy because you didn't know anybody in the industry.
Yeah.
And you gave up being an engineer, dropped out of the Delhi College of Engineering. You were studying mechanical engineering, dropped out after 3 years, and joined the film industry for the lights, camera, and action.
Yeah.
Why?
Well, it was just that I identified something, fortunately, that I really wanted to do. And to start with, I mean, like, I'll be extremely honest to you. We went to Delhi College of Engineering, but there were not many girls out there. And we were like, all right, what to do now? So my friend told me that, why don't you join a dance school?
Shyamak Davar.
Yeah. And I went there, and I discovered that whenever I was on stage as a dancer or as an actor, I would really enjoy that. And to a point that I would not know that people are judging me or anything. And I was not obsessed with what that, there were takeaways, you know, that I'm going to use this so that one day I'll become successful. Hmm. It was that, at that point of time, which mattered the most. Hmm. And it just took me, say, 2.5-3 years. Because there was a strong momentum of getting an engineering degree.
Yeah.
So it took me 2.5-3 years to actually decide to drop out. And I was like, fine, even if I don't get paid for this, I'll still do it.
Wow. So he gave many entrance exams, engineering entrance exams. He cleared all of them with flying colors. He was excellent in academics. And he comes from a family of doctors and engineers.
Yeah.
And he gave all that up to pursue his passion for arts.
And I think it's just not me. I think, as I mentioned it earlier, that it is very, very important that we need to change our definition of success and education. I'm not saying that dropping out from my engineering college was an important step. Mm-hmm. Of course, it had repercussions, and that's how we are viewing it. But the most important thing, which my mother used to tell me, was that I want you to have a very good education. Not because you will become an engineer or a doctor, but it will decide the way you think.
Absolutely.
No matter what you are. So that thing is very important. We need to tell these kids that it is okay to fail as long as you're trying to do something new.
Yeah.
As long as you're trying to do something new, as long as you're coming up with something very fresh and very personal, it is okay to fail. It is okay not to be careful. We are too careful at times.
Absolutely.
We are too careful at times, and we are just told to repeat what is probably perceived as success, which is the wrong thing to do with kids.
Deepa, aap fourth position aapne hasil kiya. Bahut thode margin se aap reh gayi, lekin aapne us din itne sare logon ke dil jeet liye. Aap sabse khaas hain, Bharat ki shaan hain, lekin is baat ko lekar bhi बहुत बढ़िया महसूस हम लोग करते हैं क्योंकि आप सबसे खतरनाक वॉल्ट करते हैं प्रोजेनोवा. इसे वॉल्ट ऑफ डेथ कहा जाता है. इसमें इफ नॉट एग्जीक्यूटेड प्रॉपरली यू कुड इवन डाई. सो आपको डर नहीं लगता?
देखिए, इसको डेथ ऑफ वॉल्ट नहीं कहते हैं.
नहीं कहते?
मीडिया ने नाम दिया.
मीडिया ने दे दिया. मीडिया को ब्लेम कर दिया आपने.
ये नहीं, ये इसका प्रोजेनोवा है. हैंडप्रिंट डबल है उसका नाम. सारा चीज में रिक्स तो है ही, बट जो हम ज्यादा प्रैक्टिस कर ले हमारे लिए इजी हो गए.
ये तो आप ये तो आप हैं कि जो ऐसा मानती हैं, आपकी जो कंपेटिटर हैं सिमोन बाइल्स, उन्होंने भी आपको डेयर डेविल का नाम दिया है और वो खुद कहती हैं कि मैं नहीं कर सकती प्रोदुनोवा जो आप करती हैं।
बट कुछ पाने के लिए तो रिस्क लेना ही पड़ता है। शायद आज मैं ये वॉल्ट नहीं करती तो पूरे इंडिया, पूरे जिमनास्टिक्स को लोग नहीं जानते।
बहुत बढ़िया बात है। And if you speak to Deepa, she'll tell you that I want the vault Prodanova to become more famous than what she is today. Coach Nandi ji, aaj Deepa agar yahan is maqam tak pahunchi hain, wo aapke sare efforts ki wajah se hi pahunchi hain. Deepa ka flat foot tha, ye hum sab jante hain, jo ki gymnast ke liye bilkul bhi favorable nahi hota. Usse aap na hi jump kar sakte hain, na hi spring kar sakte hain. Lekin aapne itni mehnat ki Deepa ke saath aur usko bhi aapne फाइट किया और कर्व उसके पाँव में आया।
एक्चुअली मैं जब जिमनास्टिक करते थे तो मेरा भी सपना था कि ओलंपिक पोडियम तक पहुंचने का।
अच्छा।
तो हो नहीं सका मेरे से, तो इसके बाद सोचा चलो स्टूडेंट को देखते हैं।
जी।
दीपा एक्चुअली मेरे को मिला 2001 पे, तब से मैं उसको लेके टारगेट में हूँ। एक स्पोर्ट्स साइंटिस्ट आया था कलकत्ता से अगरतला में, तो मेरे पास तीन लड़की थे तो मैंने उनको लेके गया। तो दीपा को देख के बता दिया नहीं, इसके तो जिमनास्टिक के लिए थोड़ा सा मुश्किल है। क्योंकि जिमनास्टिक में सभी मूवमेंट जंपिंग मूवमेंट होता है, ट्विस्टिंग मूवमेंट है, तो फ्लैट फुट के लिए थोड़ा सा डिसएडवांटेज है
जी।
तो मेरे को ये पता था कि फ्लैट फुट से कैसे कार्प फुट करना है
जी।
तो मैंने उनको पूछा और इसका बॉडी कैसा है, कहते हैं बहुत स्ट्रांग है ये, बहुत जिद्दी लड़की है, अगर उसका फ्लैट फुट से कार फुट में आ जाए तो कुछ कर सकती है। मैंने कहा ठीक है।
तो आपने बस तब से इस पर इतनी मेहनत की
है। मैं इसके,
लेकिन आप दोनों से पूछना चाहूंगी कि दीपा आपने 6 साल की उम्र से ट्रेनिंग शुरू करी, लेकिन कितनी आपको दिक्कतें आपके सामने आई, आपने उनका डट कर मुकाबला किया।
देखिए
फंडिंग नहीं थी, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर नहीं था, इसके बावजूद आप डटी रही, और कोई होता तो दे वुड हैव गिवन अप।
हाँ शायद वही, बट प्रॉब्लम तो बहुत कुछ फेस करना पड़ा, बट मेरे साथ मेरे कोच थे जिन्होंने वो मुझे फेस करने नहीं दिया, मेरे पेरेंट्स थे, बट सर की इतना मेहनत थी, जो मैं ऐसे स्टेट से बिलोंग करती हूँ वो भी नहीं जानते थे लोग, पूछते बांग्लादेश में है क्या त्रिपुरा, तो मुझे बहुत बुरा लगता था वो चीज़। बट आज सब त्रिपुरा को जानते, जिमनास्टिक्स को जानते, जो जिमनास्टिक्स बोलते सिर्फ बॉयज़ करते, वो क्या सर्कस है क्या, बट आज वो भी लोग जाने कि नहीं वो भी गेम है जो हमारे इंडिया को बहुत ऊपर तक पहुंचा सकते हैं, मेडल दे सकते हैं ओलंपिक में। तो अभी हमें बहुत प्राउड फील होती है कि हमारी स्टेट को भी जाने, हमारे इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर भी बहुत अच्छे हो गए और जिमनास्टिक्स भी बहुत पॉपुलर
है। एंड यू हैव सो मेनी फैंस, यू हैव सो मेनी फैंस दीपा। सचिन तेंदुलकर इज़ अ ह्यूज फैन, ही कॉल्स यू एन इंस्पिरेशन, उन्होंने ट्वीट भी किया था आपके बारे में बहुत बार, बहुत गर्व की बात है।